spirit that will cause you to last. There are too many leaders that when they face crisis and opposition, they are ready to throw in the towel and walk away. Now, I don't know about you pastors, but this is what I've seen. And we shouldn't see that this year. When you face opposition as a leader, the first thing that you don't do is quit.
Come on.
I've seen too many leaders face opposition and they say, well, Pastor, I need to step away for a while. No, that's your position to stand. You ought to want to stand now more than you have ever stood. Because it's in the midst of those crises, it's in the midst of those storms that you are developed, that you're growing, that you're lasting. Because what's this? I told you earlier, Pastor Ron here was kicked out of a thriving Baptist church. And they opposed and they kicked him out and told him he's no longer welcome. They took all of your keys and they said if he ever show up again, they're going to have him arrested. Do you think that stopped him? Matter of fact, when he walked away from the church, how many people walked away with you? About 95 people left that church because they were willing to obey what God had put in his heart to do. So what he taught tonight is not just some Bible study that he developed. This is where he lived at. And let me tell you what, on top of that, he had been up under attack in his body. I mean, I think it was shingles, there was a lot of other things that you've been up under attack, but he never let that cause him to walk away from God. Because he had courage to stay and courage to last. This is going to be a great year for the body of Christ. But it's going to take courage. It's going to take courage. It's going to, watch this. When people don't always see what a leader sees. But leader, you can't get discouraged. It takes courage to stand. Do you not know when David's men was ready to stone him? It took courage for David to get up from crying and begin to turn himself towards the Lord and begin to encourage himself in the Lord. Leaders, you got to know how to encourage yourself in the Lord. Amen. Everybody say, encourage.
Encourage.
Myself.
Myself.
In the Lord.
In the Lord.
This is a year of great manifestation. So this is what God is sending in. Now, let me tell you what I told you. He's Pastor Runner Smith. But he operated in the prophetic. Matter of fact, he's a prophet. And this was a prophetic word tonight. This just wasn't a logos. This was a prophetic word. That's why the anointing, amen, accommodated this. Now what you got to do is take this and make it personal. You got to make it personal. Courage in the midst of crisis. You know, I got a phone call today from one of my members. They said, Pastor, we're praying for you. We heard about your brother. We're praying for you. And I know it hadn't set in yet. I stopped. said, I'm fully awake. I said, but I don't allow my emotions to take me where the Spirit is not leading me. See, you can't, too many of us let our emotion overrule the Spirit. You are not natural having a spiritual experience. You are spiritual having a natural experience. The Bible said Jesus had to learn how to be a man. Somebody catch that point. He didn't know how to be natural. He had to learn how to be natural. What's this? You are a spirit living in a body, possessing a soul. Your spirit is always encouraged. I said your spirit is always encouraged. When I don't have money in the bank, my spirit is encouraged. When my mortgage can't get paid, now these things are not happening right now, unless you have. I have to say that because I don't want somebody to think, well, I need to help Pastor out. My pastor's all right. God has. Amen. But you gotta get to a place that you are a good courage. You have good courage. I can't even tell you the things that I've had to walk through over these 23 years. But I've allowed myself to take courage in the midst of the crisis. Yes. Same God that operated my life. I would come here, Pastor.
Pastoring is South Korea.
Where about in South Korea?
Two locations, Seoul and Pyeongchang.
What was the last year they was telling y'all that North Korea is about to bomb South Korea? Were y'all ever fearful of that?
No, sir.
Why not?
Cursed by the Lord. We knew the Lord.
They never got all of the threats that have come. His wife called me from South Korea and said, Dad, my mama, my family's telling me I should come from over South Korea with all these threats. But y'all was determined to stand in the midst. Folks, this is not play. They are right there on the border of North Korea. But they have so much courage in God that they have not packed up, they have not moved, they have trusted God. It takes courage. It takes courage as a believer to stand when your life is threatened. It takes courage when you don't see how you're going to get through things. And guess what? God wouldn't say be of good courage if you couldn't. He wouldn't say something to you like that if you weren't capable. You are capable. Are you not, Pastor?
Amen.
You are capable. Thank you, sir. Amen. So this word tonight came to every one of us. Because what did you hear, Bishop? I heard it's going to be a great year, but there's going to be some crises. But in the midst of those crises, you got to be of good courage. You got to be of good courage. Amen. Like Pastor Ron say, amen. We have to prepare ourselves for whatever come our way. We're going to be of good courage. Amen. Did y'all get something out of that?